Alan Bryant and the Four Kings, right?
Right.
Are you the only king left?
I believe so.
Yeah.
I believe so.
Ladies and gentlemen, this guy is historic in our city. There's a group called Willie Mitchell and Four Kings.
That's right.
And they had all kind of stars in that group in later years. And everybody in Memphis used to go over there late at night to hear you guys pick. And man, Elvis even rented the Manhattan Club.
He sure did.
One night.
For a birthday party, I believe it was.
Yeah, sure did. But a lot of people came over there and hung out with you guys, didn't they, Dave?
Yes, it did. We were playing rather late, you know, like up until 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
So when some of the other clubs would close up, musicians would come by and artists would come by, you know, just to sit in with us.
Yeah. I remember a guy named Billy Hill at one time owned that club, I think.
Yes, he did.
Billy Hill. I don't know what happened to him. He was a cool guy.
Yeah, he was pretty cool. Yeah.
But Donald, also, didn't you play over in West Memphis at one of those clubs?
At Danny's Club.
Danny's Club?
Danny's Club in West Memphis.
Wow.
Yeah, we played with the group played with Willie there like maybe 4-5 nights a week.
Is that right?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, that's where I first got my start with Willie.
Oh, really?
At Danny's Club.
At Danny's Club in West Memphis.
That's right. It was a group, like every band had a vocal group with them. And the group that was with Willie, I don't know, something happened and they broke up. And he needed another group to work with. And somebody mentioned our name to him. And we went and talked with him. He said, I'll give you a try, you know. So we worked up a few songs with him. And he said, okay.
Willie was a good guy to work for, though, wasn't he?
He was. He sure was.
Really a pro and... I had a lot of fun working with. We used to go over and hang out just to hear him talk, you know.
All right. He
told funny stories about music and how he discovered Al Green up in Michigan somewhere and brought him down here. And he really helped Al Green's career, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. I don't know. Once them two got together, it seemed like it was a magical thing, you know. They worked it, and hey, it came off beautiful.
Now, I noticed in the Memphis paper that you're going to be at this summer at the Shell,
yes.
The Overton Park Shell. Are you going to have some guys with you, or are you going to do a solo or what?
Well, I'll probably, I'm not sure whether it'll be a solo or not. I think it will be with Scott Beaumont and
Key's
band. And I'm not sure about the, you know.
They got good sound over there, too.
They sure have. I played there before, and I really like the sound over there.
You know, Elvis, when he was first starting out, he played the Shell.
Okay.
We did one night. It was a country music show, but Elvis did one song, and that's where it all started.
All right. Yeah. That's all it takes.
Yeah.
It takes that one.
Donald, where'd you go to high school?
I went to high school at Booker T. Washington.
Booker T. Washington.
Yes, I did.
Man, you didn't go to no Booker T.
Booker T.
Because we tried to cut people... Rufus Thomas went to Booker T. Washington, and those guys went to L.A. and became big stars. And
well, Booker T. had, I mean, it was talent all over the city, but Booker T. seemed to have had the most talent to come
Carla
out.
Carla Thomas, she came out of there, didn't she?
I believe she did.
Yeah. So where you been hiding all this time, man?
Well, just keeping it low key, keeping, you know, I've been writing, I'm continuously... been singing, you know. I did just some things. Writing has basically been, you know, my thing.
Yeah, yeah.
And once I got into it and enjoyed it, it just any time, you
because
know,
it's
just
very
a, just
creative. To
just
say
a
that
word can create a, you know, a song will come to mind. Yeah. You know, a lot of times I don't have time to put them down, but you know, I like to go back and try to remember them, but.
You know, I didn't know that Drake, the rapper, his daddy, Dennis, was a drummer over there.
Oh.
He looked a little like Willie's brother or something. Had blue eyes. Drake, you know, the rapper.
Yeah, I know who you're talking
and
about.
And his daddy, I think his name is Dennis.
Mm-hmm.
And once in a while, Willie would call him and he'd come in and play on the
session.
Oh,
okay. Well, see, Willie had contact with some of everybody, you know. And basically, me being there, I was mostly involved with vocal. Things, you know. So sometimes when the bands would come in, if I did not have to be there, you know, sometimes I wouldn't be there for a lot of the sessions he did, just musical sessions. And I missed out on meeting a lot of people, but, you know, hey, the time that I was there, hey, I enjoyed it.
It was a lot of fun, wasn't
it? It was, you know.
What were any, and I'm being serious now, are you the only king left of Donald Bryant and the Four Kings?
Yes, I believe I'm the...
They've all passed away except
yes,
for you, huh?
Yes, uh-huh.
Well, man, you saw some stuff go through the music world, didn't you?
I sure did, and hey, it was beautiful. I saw it developing, and I saw it play out, you know, like, especially with, you know, the artists coming into High Records, you know.
Joe Kugi from the record company, from Papa Tunes, he owned that.
Yes, he did.
And also, I remember for a while, it wasn't just an African-American deal over there, because I saw some pictures, Chip Smallman, Reggie Young, and musicians were playing.
Well,
playing behind somebody over there.
Well,
Bill Black had a combo.
When I first came in, Bill Black, Ace Cannon.
Yeah.
Gene Simmons.
That's right.
The Haunted House, you know.
Yeah.
All these artists were there then, you know, and when Willie came in, he started producing with them and what have you, and I was vocal with his band then.
Yeah. Oh, with Willie?
Yeah. And he started, you know, producing with the different artists, what have you, and finally got around to me.
Well, Willie Mitchell was a nice cat, wasn't he?
He was. You know,
that's why
we all called him Papa Willie.
Papa Willie,
Papa
man.
Papa Willie.
But, and if he knew you, and you said, hey, Willie, I ain't got a new, can I come and watch you? Who are you recording? Well, I'm cutting Jackie Wilson, or I'm cutting... Yeah, come on over and hang out with me.
Yeah.
We go over and hang out.
All right.
You go in the control room, just watch him do his thing, you know.
Well, like I say, it was a lot of artists that came through that, they were well-known artists. But like I say, if I wasn't involved maybe with presenting a song or something like that, I was young then, you know. And a lot of that wasn't really on my mind. I was basically concerned about my career. And
wow.
When they would come in, you know, I would... maybe be somewhere else, but you know, like, it was life for me.
Well, I bet it was a lot of fun, wasn't it?
It was, definitely so.
Man, he had a group, folks, called Donald Bryant and the Four
Kings,
right?
Donald Bryant and the Four Kings, that's right.
Man, they cut some beautiful music. It's a shame that we're not doing as much as we did in the past, but I think somehow it's going to come back.
Well, I certainly believe it. The situation now with my new album, went back and picked up some of the old things that I wrote when I was there at High, you know.
And also Boo Mitchell, who was connected to Willie,
mm-hmm.
he does a lot of stuff over there too, doesn't he?
Yes, he's still working there. He's still there and doing some great things over there too.
Well, he's a nice guy, man.
Yeah.
Reminds me a lot of Willie, you know.
Oh, yeah.
He laughs. You tell a Willie Mitchell story. And I told him a story about how Willie, I was on a radio station in Memphis, and Willie just cut up. He was on Home of the Blues label down from Beale Street. Remember the little label?
Yes, I certainly do.
The Cherries had it. Mr. and Ms. Cherry had it.
Yeah.
And Willie had a song called, I was trying to think of the title of the song. And so I called Willie. I said, Willie, we just went on your record. He said, okay, GK, lay on it, man, lay
all
on
right,
it.
All
so
right.
Then about 2 months later, I called him by. I said, Willie, I said, hate to tell you, but Ray Charles just came out with One Mint Julep. That was the song.
Oh,
and Ray Charles
okay.
covered him on it. You know?
Okay.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Don Bryant and the Four Kings, they're going to be at the Shell, the Overland Park Shell, coming up this summer sometime in June or something like that.
I
think it is. And I'm going to tell you, folks, it's worth it to go out and hear this guy do his thing because he has a lot of talent. He played on a lot of big hit records that came out of Memphis over that High with Willie Mitchell and those people. And Don, I'm going to be out in the audience too checking you out.
All right. It sounds okay. Good, George. Thank
okay.
you, George.
Thanks for coming down.
All right.
One of the nicest guys in the business, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Donald Bryant, formerly of Donald Bryant and the Four Kings.